Even though most of our communication today is done via email, there are still times when you want to send out letters. Whenever you write a letter, you should make sure that it's personalized. Your readers will be much more inclined to read the letter if they feel that it's addressed uniquely to them. In this video, you'll learn how to use Mail Merge in Word 2013 to automate the process of personalizing multiple letters. You'll also learn how to add some flexibility to your letter so that you can use the template multiple times. On November 4th, we're having a business productivity workshop for one of our customers. The attendees will be arriving to the hotel the night before the workshop. When they arrive, each of the 14 participants will be given this welcoming letter, printed out on a piece of paper. The letter will greet each participant by first name. The date of the letter should be the date before the event. The name of the hotel and the conference room where the workshop will be held should also be added to the letter.
Hi, I'm so sorry to interrupt. I just wanted to let you know that if you're annoyed by the ads in this video, you can access our tutorials ad-free by getting a subscription to businessproductivity.com or signing up for one of our many courses on platforms such as Udemy, CyberU, and Vimeo On Demand. I also wanted to take this opportunity to tell you a bit more about Storyals. Storyals, which stands for Story-Based Tutorials, is our video package offering for organizations that want to increase employee productivity using Office 365. With Storyals, organizations can inspire, motivate, and educate users on effective use of Office 365 by showcasing real-life best practices. Finally, I want to encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channels, Business Productivity and Storyals. Here you will also find my video blog, Succeed in the Digital Workplace, as well as other videos that can help you increase your productivity. If you have any questions or comments, please post them here and I'll do my very best to get back to you. With that, let's go back to the tutorial. Thank you for watching.
I could just write in the date, hotel, and conference room into the letter, but since I want to make this into a reusable template that we can use multiple times, I'll add some flexibility here so that we can easily change this information next time we use the template. Finally, each of the participants will be assigned into a team, team number 1 or team number 2, depending on which department they belong to. So I'm going to add some logic into the letter to assign each participant to the right team. Here is the welcome letter in Word. I've highlighted the fields that will vary in yellow. To start using Mail Merge, go to the Mailings tab and click Start Mail Merge. Here you can select what type of document you want to create, or if you want step-by-step guidance, you can select the step-by-step mail merge wizard. First, you need to decide what the outcome should be of your mail merge: letters, email messages, envelopes, and so on. In this case, I want to create personalized letters to print out, so I'll select the first option, which is letters. The second step is to select starting document, and I'll leave the default option, which is Use Current Document. The next step is to select recipients. You can select recipients from a number of different sources. You can use an existing list, like an Excel spreadsheet or an Access database. You can select recipients from your Outlook contacts, or you can type them into a new list by hand. I want to personalize letters to the employees of the company BPG group that I have in my Outlook contacts. Since I'm going to filter on the company name, I need to make sure that all the contacts have the company field entered correctly. I'm also going to use the first name field, so I'll check to see that I have the names of all the people in my contacts. To select my Outlook contacts, I'll click Select from Outlook Contacts. Here, I can select between the different contact folders I have in Outlook, and I'm going to select my main contacts folder, which is associated with my business email account. Then I'll click OK. Here, I'll get all of the contacts that I have in my contacts folder, and I only want to select the ones from the company BPG group. So to do that, I'll click Filter. I'll click the field drop-down and select Company. I'll leave the default comparison, which is equal to. and then I'll type in the company name in the Compare To text field and click OK. Now, only the contacts from the BPG group will be selected for the mail merge. You can always go back and edit the recipient list at a later stage by clicking Edit Recipient List. When I've selected my recipients, I'll go to the next step of the wizard, which is to write the letter. First, I want to add the greeting line and the first name. So I'll just delete my placeholder text and click Greeting Line, either on the Mailings menu or in the Mail Merge wizard. Here, I can select between different greeting lines. I'll select Dear and then the first name. So I'll scroll down and select the first name. A comma is automatically inserted after the greeting line. I can also select which greeting line I want to have if the recipient name is missing. And I'll just leave the default Dear Sir or Madam. Here I can see a preview of my recipient list and it looks good, so I'll just click OK. When a mail merge field has been inserted into your letter, you'll see the name of the field inside two tags. If you want to add additional fields from the contacts, such as the postal address or email address, just click Insert Merge Fields on the Mailings menu or click More Items in the Mail Merge wizard and select the appropriate fields from the list. If you want to see what the actual letters will look like when they're done, just click Preview Results and then you can step through the recipients in the list by clicking the back and forth arrows. Next, I want to insert the date. I want this to be flexible. I'll click Rules and select Fill In. In the Prompt field, I'll enter the text that I'll be prompted to fill in when I open up this letter template. So here I'll write Letter Date. I can select to have a default fill in, but I'll leave this blank. By default, the Word template will automatically populate this with the Latest Use field anyway. At the bottom of the message box, there's an option called Ask Once. If I mark this checkbox, the same date will be used for all letters without asking about the letter date for each one. Since the date should be the same for all letters, I'll mark the checkbox and then I'll click OK. I'm prompted right away for the letter date, so I'll enter November 3rd, 2014. I'll click OK, and as you can see, the date is inserted into my letter. Now, I'll do the same thing for the hotel and the conference room, since these will likely change next time we have a workshop and want to use this letter. There, now these fields have all been inserted into my document. The final field I want to add to the letter is the team number. Everyone in the sales department should be in team number 1, and everyone else should be in team number 2. I'm going to use the department field in the Outlook contact to determine the team number for each attendee. Here I can see that Abdullah, who is a sales representative, doesn't have the department field filled out. So I'll just update the department field in Outlook to sales. I'll go back to the invitation letter and delete the placeholder text for the team number and click Rules. Here I'll select If Then Else. In the field name drop-down, I'll select Department. I'll leave the comparison as equal to, and then in the Compare To field, I'll enter Sales. In the Insert This text box, I'll write the number 1. In the Otherwise Insert This text box, I'll enter the number 2 and then click OK. If I scroll down, now you can see that the team number has been inserted into the letter. I'll mark the number and change the formatting to italic so that it's consistent with the rest of the text. On the Mailings tab, I'll step through some of the recipients to make sure that the team numbers are assigned correctly. Now I'm done with the welcome letter. I'll step through the remaining steps in the Mail Merge wizard. I've already previewed my letters, so I'll go to the sixth and final step, which is to complete the Mail Merge. Here you can select between Print and Edit Individual Documents. If you select Print, this will send the letters directly to the printer. You won't have the option to save the individual letters as a reference. Instead, I recommend that you select Edit Individual Letters. If you're not using the Mail Merge wizard, you can accomplish the same thing by clicking Finish and Merge and selecting Edit Individual Documents. I'll select this option, and here I can select if I want to generate a selection of the recipient letters or all of them. I'll select all and then enter the fields that I'm prompted for. The result is a 14-page long document with a unique page for each recipient. I'll click File and Save, and then I'll save this document for future reference. Unfortunately, there's no option here to create the letters as individual files, which might be useful if you also want to email a welcoming letter to each recipient. Now that I've reviewed and saved the letters, I'll print them. After that, I'll close down the document with the 14 pages. Next, I'll save the changes to my letter template and close it down as well. Next time I open up the letter template for our next workshop, I'll get a warning message telling me that opening this document will run a SQL command. Click Yes here and select the Contacts folder from Outlook. To use the template again, just click the Mailings tab and make the changes you need to your new welcome letter. Using Mail Merge, I've saved a lot of time by automating the process of personalizing multiple letters.